You know, Mary, advocates for the poor filed a lawsuit yesterday in federal court, and a judge is going to hear their case on Tuesday. They say that this is dangerous, that it puts thousands of families in a dangerous position where they can't support themselves. Hundreds gathered for three rallies this week. They say changes in Michigan's welfare system will hurt Michigan families.
I am so incredibly upset about what they're doing to these children. These children have no responsibility for anything, but they're cutting all the money off to these children.
Children like Kathleen Digasses. She has two and has been on welfare since her 10-year-old son was born. He is disabled and needs extra care.
It would be hard to hold a job. I mean, not too many employers are going to put up with you being absent a lot in the winter and fall and spring because my son's been sick for most of his life.
The state will still pay cash benefits for her son because he is disabled, but Digas says she's been told the $403 a month designated for her will stop coming as of today. The new rules limit able-bodied residents to 4 years on assistance. Digas is one of several who filed suit yesterday asking a federal judge to stop the changes. She says they leave her without enough income to meet her family's basic needs. Governor Rick Snyder says the stricter program will save the state $60 million a year and stop people from abusing the system.
Family Independence Program cash assistance was never intended to be a long-term support, but rather a safety net for those in need of temporary assistance.
Now these changes go into effect today because the new budget year starts, and that means there's also other cuts coming. For example, schools will see up to $300 per student in cuts effective today. Kim Russell, Channel 7 Action News.